You have not seen this group before and participated with them, you're in for a treat today. So I would like to, at this time, bring your attention to one of the greatest resources we have here in the Quad Cities. You're going to really enjoy yourself with hand and heart drumming in the Quad Cities. Let's hear a big round of applause for them as they come to the stage.
Jumbo! That's a greeting in Swahili. Let me hear you say, Jumbo! Yeah, it's not loud enough though. Jumbo!
Okay, I got my speaker on now.
Jumbo!
That's a greeting in Swahili. Swahili was invented by the Africans. Because in Africa, there are many, many countries close together. They needed to speak one language, so they invented Swahili. In Africa today, it is still being used. We are hand and heart drumming, and we're going to perform for you and talk about bullying today, all right? Before we do, who can tell me what bullies do over here? What do bullies do? Are they mean to you? What do bullies do, buddy? Yell it out. What do they do?
They pick on you? What else? Who likes bullies here? Anybody? No! We don't like bullies. Okay? Okay, we're going to drum for you a little bit and talk about bullying in Africans and slavery, why music is what it is today, okay? Stand by for some cool drumming.
Ready? Man.
Thank you. So, I know there's a question out there. I'm going to go ahead and answer the question for you. The question is that as smart as it looks? The answer is, yeah, it is. It's a blast up there, you know. Playing African drums is so fun. But let's talk about Africans and how they came to this country, okay? Africans came to this country as slaves. This is pretty nice. As slaves, they took all the things away from them. They took away their clothes, their family, their toys. Everything was taken from them. But the one thing they could not take from the Africans was their rhythm. That was their power. Their rhythm and their drumming was power to the African people. And the African people retained that throughout slavery. How do we know this? How do we know that Africans retain their power? Let's find out. This instrument is a European instrument called a harmonica. Comes from Europe, okay? When the Africans came in touch with this instrument, they played it differently than the Europeans. Europeans played it like this. That's the way the Europeans played the instrument. The Africans didn't have the same experience. Their experience was one of sorrow, one of hopelessness, one of joy sometimes. They took the same instrument and played it like this. The blues gave birth to the music we have today. The blues gave birth to rock and roll, to jazz, to hip-hop, to funk, the rhythm and blues, to country, all came from the African experience with European harmonics. So without them keeping their power, you see, they wouldn't have this music. So what do boys want from you? They want to pick on you, they want to call you Four Eyes. Who's been bullied about your glasses? Anybody raise your hand? I have. Who's been bullied about your hair? Yeah, totally. Who's been bullied about the color of your skin? I have. My freckles. You see, we've all been bullied in some way. But what do bullies want the most? I can tell you that. The thing that bullies want the most, they want your power. They want your power. They want to take your power from you. The only way a boy can have your power is if you give permission for them to take it. You cannot allow them to take it. If you allow a boy to take your power, they will. They'll put you on Facebook, won't they? Snapchat, whatever it is, they will put power, they'll take your power away. They'll put you on some form of internet exposure that'll make you feel sad, cry. I've seen people actually hurt themselves because of bullying. We don't want that to happen. So even as young people, even old people, some of us, we can all learn not to give our power away, just like the slaves did not give their power away. Thank you.
Thank you!